Good day to all of us. I hope everything is working fine. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. I saw a post from someone in Facebook group and it caught my attention because the post was a question regarding the concrete column and beam design using the STAAD and Rcdc software, which is quite similar to that of my subscribers who have recently asked me about. He did not actually share his file, but as I scrutinized his post, the tune of the problem was really very similar. It seems I had already a STAAD file similar to this problem to keep on asking me on what was the error in the stick model, why they couldn't redesign the concrete beams. Actually, there were no errors in the model, and definitely the cause of that failure to design was just simply there was a design code in NSCP or ECI code that was not properly addressed, and that could be one of the causes of failure. I think this is it. So here, in this post, if you notice, whatever value given for the depth and width of the members, yet the software wouldn't accept these values, meaning fail, meaning the members didn't meet the requirements, and the members were not safe for construction. Now stay tuned in, guys, because this is what we are going to tackle in this video. I'm gonna show you what code is that in NSCP in particular that prevents you in the design. Now let me open the file that I have. I'm gonna show you how the members feel, how the situation gets to the point that it is somewhat impossible to design the beams. This is our stick module. The structure has no soft story, and for the irregularity condition, there is nothing here. I will invoke a command to give us information about irregularity check. Let me go to Analysis and Design tab, then hover to Miscellaneous Commands, then Floor Diaphragm. There we go, the check irregularities, directly right below the check soft stories, okay? Click it, and of course the design code must be ASCE7. Don't forget to select it in the drop down menu. Then click OK. Then run analysis. And so the structure has no irregularity found, and it must be our customary to check this always in any structure that we are designing. Now we will head directly to RCDC to check the member's strength and stability. Take note, these beams have no problem. Let us check the other beams here. These beams here. Field. Let's increase value. Still field. One more. Let's increase the value. Still the same, no luck. This one here, let us try. Failed again. Another one down here. Let us try. Still no luck. These beams here, let's try. So we see that no matter what value we feed in there, the problem is still perpetuates. Now let us check the status of columns and sit aside for a while the beams, because it seems tedious to continue designing the beams with this circumstance.
dyan.
According to NSCP 418.8.2.3, where longitudinal beam reinforcement extends through a beam column joint, the column dimension parallel to the beam reinforcement shall be at least 20 times the diameter of the largest longitudinal beam bar for normal weight concrete, or 26 times the diameter of the largest longitudinal bar for lightweight concrete. This particular code here talks about column dimension in relation to beam reinforcement. The maximum reinforcement size of the beam passing to column, or shall we say column beam joint, this column beam joint here. So in our model, 16 mm diameter is the reinforcement of the beam. So the column size parallel to this beam here is 16 times 20, which is equal to 320 mm. So therefore, this side here is 320 mm. In the adjacent side here has no problem. So what we gonna do now? We must resize our column following this new size. So let's do this. Let's see afterwards what will happen. So from 250, we'll make it 320, right? Or let us make it 350 instead. So now we found out that there were no really problems with the beams, and there were no problems about the modeling. By changing the size of columns only, the beams have now met the design requirements, and the beams are now okay. Just simply follow the design code and everything is fine. I hope you learned something in this tutorial, and if you do, please don't forget to like this video, and if you are new to this channel, please subscribe to this YouTube channel and hit the notification bell for more updates and more tutorials like this. Thanks for watching, and till we meet again for our next episode. Bye!